By the time my tenure is ended, Osun State will be comparable to any other university in Nigeria. And I'm happy to see that this is part of that development. And I must congratulate this foundation for this gesture. When you look at the communities from which these students are drawn from, and you look at the parents, the families, most of them are indigents. It is painful when occasionally we ask our students to go because of money, because of school fees. It's not that the vice chancellor is wicked, it's not that the principal's officers are wicked, but for the fact that there is a policy. Personally, I paid some students' fee in the last one. So I sincerely appreciate this effort. And at the end of the day, I pray that these students who are going to be beneficiaries of this award, of this scholarship, will also still believe to reciprocate this very good gesture when they are in places that are much, much better. When I came in, I saw my chief. He was the first person I met. Even when I came for the interview, although I did not tell him I was here for interview, I stayed with him in his outfit somewhere there. And we were discussing. And I saw that he had been a very, very nice person to relate with. And I was begging him to pardon my lapses, because we should have been more deeper than this. So, sir, I appreciate you and thank you. Sir, once again, without wasting much of our time, it's going to be on record. The name of this foundation is going to be written in gold, and it will be part of Osun State history. When we are having a convocation, important things, this will be mentioned. And we shall continue to mention this as long as Osun State exists. And it is my prayers that our new organization, you, and the name will continue to be projected. It will be projected every now and then when we talk about the development of Osun State. Thank you very much. And I do the University of
I think we can do better. Aki Amakadeo! Aki Jamunda! Perhaps maybe this is not sounding meaningful to some of the children.
My Vice Chancellor and the Principal Officers of the University, the awardees and the parents, the press crew, ladies and gentlemen, kindly pardon me if I miss anybody out. My responsibility in the next few minutes is to introduce the chairman and the foundation, Tolani Iyola Ayegu Educational Support Foundation. If I will start with the introduction of the chairman, I will have to mention about how I came across him. My first encounter with him, his family background, education and work experience, his life after retirement, and the urge to give back to the community. And then I will talk on the foundation. My first encounter with the man. I met this gentle, humble, philanthropic, and good-hearted man named the Chief Dr. Iyola Ayegu, the Olowo-Oyega III, the third of Igbo People Kingdom, for the first time in early in the year 2016. During one of his visits to Nigeria. Then, when I was the acting vice chancellor of this university, out of his interest and curiosity for the growth and development of the university. Our encounter and discussions were focused on the funding challenges confronting the university then, which prompted him to decide to meet the then visitor of the state governor, Dr. Olusegun Emeka. Since then, we have built on the relationship and we are now good friends, though he is far older than me. Our families are also good friends. His family background, educational work experience. Dr. Iolaye, who was born into a royal family, the Ayegu dynasty of the Igbo kingdom some decades ago. Don't ask me, please. After his primary and secondary school education, he left the shores of Nigeria for United States of America for his tertiary education and professional trainings about 45 years ago. He has since then become an American citizen. So he doesn't need visa to enter America, even if Trump says Nigerians cannot come. He attended the following schools in Nigeria: LA Primary School, Mahi Ilaje; Anglican Mother School, Itepe Okitipupa; Methodist High School, Okitipupa. He worked briefly in Nigeria before proceeding to the United States for his tertiary education in the following institutions: Washington State University, Pullman, for his BSc degree; Western Washington University, Cheney, for his Master's in Urban and Regional Planning; the City University of the State of New York, for professional nursing degree, so he's a registered professional nurse; Bill Wilson School of Ministry, Chicago; Satellite Campus, Power and Authority Evangelical Ministry, Rocking, New York. So he's also an ordained minister of God. Pacific Western University, Eneco, California, for his PhD. He worked in the following places in the United States of America: Region 10, New York State Development Department of Transportation. Region 10, New York State Department of Transportation Planning, as Chief Executive 1, Project Development and Funding. He retired from there in April 2008. He also worked in various private and public hospitals, such as PHS, Corizon, New York City Health and Hospital Corporation, as registered professional nurse. He retired finally in July 2018. He is happily married to Chief Mrs. Janet Ayegu, the Iyalaje of the Igbo Kingdom, by extension, the Iyalaje of the universe. The marriage is blessed with wonderful children and grandchildren. Life after retirement and the urge to give back to the community. Dr. Iyola Ayegu retired from active service in July 2018 and decided to return home after 45 years abroad to give back to his community of origin and to remix with his people that he has missed for several years. Apart from his establishment of a clinic in the Igbo Kingdom in collaboration with the World Health Organization, the community counterpart fund of 1 million naira has been paid. I think the project will take two. Organization of vocational skill acquisition for the unemployed youth in Igbo. which is soon commence. The third one, the Educational Support Foundation for Indigents of Okitipupa, Irele, and other parts of Ondo State. The maiden edition of the scholarship award is what we are witnessing today. Today's occasion also affords our distinguished guests and KPSCs the opportunity to see the ongoing projects and developments in OSUSPEC, which require our collective support and contributions. OSUTEC is blessed with wide expanse of land, and the gates are open for everyone for philanthropic investment. The foundation, the Iyola Tolani Ayeku Educational Support Foundation, is a non-profit, non-political and non-religious organization formed in the year 2019 by the chairman, Chief Dr. Iyola Ayeku, with the mission and mission of supporting humanity, especially indigenous students and unemployed youth in the Okitipupa, Irele and Irele local government areas in particular, and Ondo State in general. Today, the foundation will award a sum of 50,000 naira only to each of 30 OSUTEC indigenous students. Who are from Okitipupa and in the local government areas. The next edition of the award will accommodate students from other parts of Ondo State. The board members of the foundation are Chief Dr. Iyola Ayeku, the chairman. Can you please rise up for number two, the co-chairman is Mr. Tolani Iyola Ayeku. He's based in the US, he's a son to the chairman. He was in Nigeria in December and registered his apology not to be around for this, but I think he's monitoring what is going on now. Tolani Iyola Ayeku. Top is Adeboke Adebite Emmanuel as the director of the foundation. Number four is Professor Folari Olujimi Moses, member, the Dean of Faculty of Sciences. I can't remember whether I stood up when my name was once mentioned. Number five is Dr. Owobo Paul Temepi, a member of the foundation. Please, you can raise up your hand because you are already starting. Thank you. Number six, Mr. Aladeboyeje Adeboke. If you are there, please. Okay, it's the one doing it. And the secretary of the foundation is Chief Ogunsake Michael Foronsho. Part of today's program is the launching of 30 million naira endowments or scholarship fund, which will be dedicated to this, to the sustenance of this educational support program for over 15 years, which the chairman had deeply committed himself, even it will mean putting some of his assets to maintain this foundation. I pray the institution will not degenerate to this level with the support of friends and relations to actualize the same goals, national goals for Israel. I commend this kind man for his love and spirit of family and community building. His spirit of charity and his spirit of sacrifice to a path.
There is one wonderful thing we did. To some of our students, they are ordained. Many of them don't want to inform their parents, and they don't want their parents to know. And we quite understood it. We are taking a very serious step to inform the parents.
Some of them and particularly the coach here, Tolani Ayeko, I am profoundly appreciative and grateful to the members of the board. Individually and collectively, they work assiduously, relentlessly, and cooperatively. Beating my wildest expectation. Their hard work and the criteria for selecting the awardees are awesome. Also, the colorful, congenially conducive hall evidently shows the extent of their top-notch ingenuity and expertise. I thank you very much. Thank you for your work. Individually, I thank Professor M. O. Folani, Dean of Faculty of Science, Dr. P. T. Ogombo, the eminently representative of the local government, Mr. Aladebo Ije, eminently representing Okutipa local government, Chief M. F. Ogunsakun, the energetic secretary of the board. This man is wonderful. He made my expectation. Every moment, whatever I did, I have it. He's always very communicative with us, whether I'm here in this country or in the US. Thank you all again very much for your support.
And to ensure that the money is expended for the purpose intended. In pursuit of this, the university has opened Kondose University of Science and Technology scholarship account with UBA. All proceeds from this for the purpose of the scholarship with lodge into that account. And nothing, and I repeat, nothing other than the purpose intended will move that money away from that account. That is with their clearance. Therein, we will check their record and confirm the amount due to them and pay directly to the university account, which reduces the amount or set off the amount against their school fees. And if it is enough to pay, the student will be discharged. If not, whatever balance is due, the board of trustee that the purpose intended will be achieved through the commitment of the university. Thank you.
Yeah, the scholarship award program is a very good one that we have been expecting. And in fact, it is the first time within this locality for all sisters to benefit from it. It's a very good beginning for others to be beneficiaries. Some of them may expect the money to go into their pockets to buy handset and so on. But the foundation has taken a very good step by saying that money should be deposited in the university account for them to grow. So it's a very good one. So I want to assure the beneficiaries that by the time their school fees are going to be, that amount will be
politician, who is just a philanthropist to the left. And if you look at it, 30 50,000 in 30 places to begin having a at this point in time, it's quite a colossal sum of money. And we face the man. And we also enjoy other indigenous of the area that God has blessed one way or the other to come and give back, not to the university, but to the individual students. Some of the students are even finding it extremely difficult to pay their school fees, to meet up all their financial needs. But with this one, their parents will be relieved, the students themselves will be relieved, and also the
I was surprised because I never expected. So I don't have much to say than to thank Chief Dr. Ijeola Tolani Ayuk for giving me the golden opportunities to be among the beneficiaries. I say thank you, sir, and God bless you.
Emmanuel David O, Computer Science. Congratulations. Oluwa Femi, Oluwa Femi Biochemistry. Congratulations. Oba Julaye Gadebo M, Physics. Are you here? Congratulations. You are having a handshake with the chairman. Aketuli Omolade Jade, Aketuli Biochemistry. Please come and have a chance to the chairman. Iwasomi John, Biochemistry. Congratulations. Igala Titilare C, Biochemistry. Congratulations. Atishon Onrut, Bodney. Congratulations. Adeku Roye Moses, Physics. Congratulations. Omokowajo Princess, Omokowajo Princess by Biochemistry. Congratulations. Adeyeye Emmanuel, AP. Adeyeye Emmanuel, O, APH. Congratulations. Fawumi Daniel, O, Zoology. Congratulations. Solomon Medico, FST, congratulations. Oyetuyi Seyi, Microbiology, congratulations. Louis Semiloluwa, AEE, congratulations. Ari Kawe Samuel, Microbiology, congratulations. Akibo Olami Peju, Biochemistry, congratulations. Akinusi Ebenezer, Biochemistry, congratulations. Akindele Stephen O, Opni, congratulations. Adeoye Blessing M, Microbiology, congratulations. Oroye Yano A, FST, congratulations. Akinwe Iniunua Zoology, congratulations. Adeshokan Precious O, Microbiology, congratulations. May I ask if the parents of Akinlagbe Olusegun and Abayomi Benjamin are here so that they can take their letters on their behalf? Okay. What's the name? Abayomi Benjamin. That's the microbiology. Akinlagbe Olusegun. Is it?
The representative of the Commissioner for Education, you are welcome. And to my brother, Prince Dr. Ayew, I really appreciate you. And all others, to all, I really appreciate you, sir. With your financials and everybody's all welcome. When Dr. Ayew came to the palace yesterday and briefed me about this program, I was very, very happy because I have somebody of a like mind, and for the people, their passion for my people, and they explain everything as this. We are not doing lunching this year, as you are finding, I said we have to postpone it because we need to bring many people to come and contribute towards this event so that our people can benefit more. And if you can have 10 of it, like Ikale as a whole, the whole community will be changed. So for this, I appreciate you. I know that by the special grace of God, this program has come to stay, and I want to assure you that you have a lot of support because you have started this program in Ghana. Now all other people will support you, all our sons and daughters in the diaspora. We have to encourage them to come home and to come and support this program. It has come to stay, and God will sustain you, and I pray for you that you continue to go from strength to strength in Jesus' name. Long life this in Yoruba Alebu program. Long live the talent. Long live from those things and long live from Jesus. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Your Majesty. The representative of the commission.
One thing to, embark on something is another thing to get success out of it. We are very grateful to God Almighty for the moderate success that we have achieved today. My duty is to give vote of thanks. And Professor Adebite was smarter that he leaked the secret of the chairman that I also wanted to leak. This foundation, by the grace of God, has come to stay. And that is emanating from the fact that the chairman of this foundation, Chief Dr. Iyola Ayeku, had made up his mind that this foundation will outlive each and every one of us. And to ensure that, he said, although he's retired, they will put on this coat if the need arises and go back to work and raise enough money. Or the alternative is ready to even liquidate some of its assets, you know, to ensure the success of this foundation. He is the founder. And what commitment do we even need to have again? So, sir, you have decided to serve humanity in this regard. And I'm very sure God Almighty is on your side. Because you that help the poor, of course, Almighty God is the one that will actually meet you at the front of your needs. So on that note, I wish each and every one of us. I will start from our royal fathers here present and Her Majesty, Regent of Ayeka Kingdom. You are highly appreciated, man. All our traditional rulers, our high chiefs that are here present, I say thank you. God bless.
I'm impressed because I see him as a person of like mind. And it's a good initiative if our people, those who are in the diaspora, those who God has blessed, can give back to those who are less privileged, that the community will continue to give them. So you have to enjoy that. It has been overdue, but I'm very, very happy and pleased that eventually this has been done today, and I'm very grateful to the government or whoever is in charge. I really appreciate them. This will encourage people to continue to do more.
What I have done. This So what is that goal? Whatever you have to do,